Aloha everyone, it's Cindy from Stamped with Aloha. Welcome to part one of my Back on Your Feet card class series. In this series, I will be teaching you three different cards using the Back on Your Feet stamp set, and I'm also going to teach you a really cute box that all of these cards will fit inside. For this first card, we're going to use this cute little sloth here, so let's go ahead and get started. I'm going to take a piece of Whisper White cardstock, and I've scored this cardstock at 1 3/4 inches. Now I'm going to use a bone folder to make sure I have a nice, clean, flat fold. Then I'm going to grab a piece of Pool Party cardstock. This cardstock has been cut at 1.5 by 4 3/4 inches. I'm going to go ahead and put some adhesive on the back and then stick this down. And as you can see, this cardstock has been embossed with the Mosaic 3D embossing folder. The next piece I'm going to use is a piece of Pear Pizzazz cardstock, and this cardstock has been cut at 3 1/4 by 4 3/4. Now I'm going to go ahead and stamp the sentiment, and I want to stamp it all the way over in the far left corner of the cardstock. When I'm stamping a sentiment, I usually stamp before I put the adhesive, and that way if I stamp crooked, I always can flip it over and use the back. But it looked like I did this one pretty good, so we'll go ahead and put the adhesive on the back. And then we'll carefully place this on the inside of our card. Okay, and then you're just going to line it up and go ahead and press this down. Okay, the next thing we're going to do is grab a piece of Whisper White cardstock and our Memento Black ink. We'll take the sloth image from the stamp set and go ahead and stamp two of those. Aren't they so cute? I just love this stamp set. Okay, now it's time to color, so I'm going to start with a Stampin' Blends, and this is Crumb Cake color. And the first thing that I'll do is go ahead and just outline the entire image. Go around the arms, and then go around the back, and around the face. And then I'll come in and just carefully color around the face, and then because I have the outline there, it just makes it easier to just fill in all the inside areas. Now you may have noticed that the sloth has a little bandage around his arm, but we went ahead and just colored over the top of that for this particular project. So the next thing we're going to do is take a bronze Stampin' Blend, and I'm just going to add a little bit of highlights to some of the areas. So I'll put some around the head, and then on the arms, and then I'll do a little bit on the back. I'm going to go ahead and use the same color to color in the tree branch, and then I'm going to flip my marker around and use the smaller tip just to color the top of the branch there. Then I'm going to go ahead and pick up my crumb cake marker once again, and then I'm going to go ahead and just color right on top of that bronze area and just blend the two of those colors together. And it's just really fun working with these Stampin' Blends because they color so well. And then I'm going to take a dark old olive Stampin' Blend marker, and using the small tip, I'm going to color in the leaves that are on this little tree branch. Okay, so now we have him all colored out, and you would normally go ahead and color two of them because you're going to need two. And then after you color them, you're going to cut them out with your paper snips, and I've already done that, so here you go. They're going to look like this. Now let's see how we're going to put this together on the card. So you can see that some of the sentiment is sticking out, so we're going to use the sloth to cover up the words. So it's really important where you position him. So we're going to take and lay him on there just to line him up, and then I'm going to carefully fold him over and grab some dimensionals, and then I'll place one dimensional right on his head, and then peel off the backing, and then carefully look again to make sure that he's covering up the words that are stamped underneath, and then I'll just press that down. Okay, now for the second sloth, we're going to put him right underneath, but we're going to mount him to the base of the card, onto the Pear Pizzazz part. And so we're going to line him up there, and then I'm going to just hold my finger right around where the tree branch was, and then I'll take a dimensional and press that down right near that center fold of the card. So it's not going over the flap, but it's right next to it. And then I'll place another dimensional right across from that. I'll peel them, and then take this sloth, and we're going to line him up so that the branch is hitting the far right side of the card. And what happens here is when you press him down, he will now act as a latch to the card. So when you pick up the card and open it, it will be held closed when you just tuck it under that branch. So it is really, really important where you place your dimensional for that. Now, right now, we are all learning about social distancing, and it's really, really important. And so this card is going to reflect that by taking a ruler, and I'm going to use my marker to make that 6-foot mark. And so we're going to just draw a straight line to remind these cute little sloths to practice safety and to stay 6 feet away from each other, as hard as that may be. And then we are going to put a sentiment on this card. Now, I imagine if they are like me and this isolation has been a little bit of a challenge, because I am definitely somebody who enjoys being with people, this is the perfect sentiment. It just says, sigh. And it goes perfectly with the inside of the card because it says, sigh, sometimes that's all there is to say, and that I am here for you. So what a perfect message to send to people right now who might be struggling with the social distancing. So at this point, our card could be done because I've used only the items that come in the Back on Your Feet stamp set, but I've decided to add an additional stamp set so that I could put one more message inside. And so that is, the message is the Miss You stamp. I want to use that, and that comes from the Enjoy Life. And so I'm going to go ahead and use my Memento ink, and I'm going to ink up my stamp, and then I'm going to stamp that sentiment right in the center of the card. So just stamp that there, and there you go. Our message is complete, and now we've finished this cute little social distancing sloth card that is just the perfect thing to send to a friend who might be down right now. So I hope you enjoyed learning how to make this encouragement card. I look forward to showing you the other neat things I created with this stamp set. And if you haven't yet subscribed to my YouTube channel, be sure to do that so you won't miss out on any of my videos. Thank you for spending this time with me. I am praying that you will all stay healthy and safe. I look forward to stamping with you again soon. Aloha!